My name is Matteo Rizzi. I am a general partner in SBT Venture Capital, as well as an advisor for the Omidia Network. Previously, I was the co-founder of InnoTribe, as well as I worked 15 years in financial services. I just gave a presentation on the fintech space, and I call it the path to fintech greatness. The reason why I wanted to give that spin to the presentation is that I clearly think that fintech is now growing fastest than most of the industries. You see a number of accelerators and incubators and capitals, as well as banks trying to hit the space. Now it's time to look for disruption in financial services. My point was that at the moment, disruption is not really happening, because truth is that banks are just hitting what we call the low-hanging fruits, the inefficiencies of the banking business, and they are doing it faster, better, and cheaper, rather than really disrupting the industry. I also talked about the fact that financial inclusion is, to me, one of the biggest fintech opportunities. I call it banking the bottom billions. There are billions of people that are unbanked or underbanked, and there is a direct correlation between GDP growth and the financial inclusion of the population, which is why I think is one of the biggest opportunities. The importance of the accelerators and the incubators around Europe and the world for the startup ecosystem. I think that for a startup that has an idea, a team, but needs to refine their strategy, there is no better place than an accelerator to be in it. We are actually co-founders and the biggest investors of Startup Bootcamp, Startup Bootcamp Fintech. Actually, we are not co-founders, we are the largest investors, to be precise, but we kind of spin it, you know, from the very beginning with SBT Venture Capital. And we saw already a few batches of companies that really shaped their product and their solution from something that was not sellable at the moment, but they came out after the 4 months of the program with something that was not only investable, but ready to hit the market. The main reason why I think accelerators and incubators are fundamental for the startup industry, even if I'm talking vertically, you know, about the fintech one, is the fact that most of the accelerators are actually connected with not only the technology partners, as well as with the financial industry players. And if you are a fintech startup that tries to sell to banks, it is impossible to knock at the bank's door and get the door open. So accelerators are building these networks for the startups while the startup is actually refining their value proposition and their go-to-market approach. That's why I think it's fundamental. There are obviously, you know, I'm biased in a way I look at startups, because I do not look at startups that are not into the fintech or the financial inclusion space. But I can certainly tell that the few that I have seen that are hitting the space are actually extremely compelling for the market. I don't know if I can name a few, but I just met the CEO of Currency One, and these guys in the remittance space, they're doing a great job. But their volume they're doing in Poland is actually, you know, quite compelling, even compared with you know, well-funded startups from other countries. I think that the reason why Poland for fintech has a great potential is because the mobile culture. Also, you know, Poland is one of the, if not the highest adoption rates of the NFCs, I think. So this gives also the right mentality, you know, for the retail market to approach new service. So once someone is able to pay with his phone, then you can plug loyalty, and then you can plug data, and on the top of data you can plug other financial services such as loans and stuff. So it is definitely the right playground to start building a successful fintech ecosystem. So I was hit by many emails, and I managed to connect with a bunch of people through the platform. I think it worked okay. What I did, to be totally frank, is that I scrolled the attendees list, and I tried to figure out which one was the best, to get connected. Now, I think that the B2B tool could definitely be improved, because the way that you is not intuitive, the way you can fix and move meetings. But, you know, I'm a conference organizer myself, so I have my own brand. It's called Fintech Stage. It is actually a fintech conference. We have done a few conferences already in Milan, in Barcelona, and now we go to Buenos Aires. And making people networking at conferences is the biggest challenge for any conference organizer. So I think that I give credit to World Summit to at least put in place the right tools. Then, of course, the challenge is to get the audience to use it in the best way. And because we are all busy people, you know, if it's not super intuitive, your attention might drop. But I think this one was actually quite efficient. Don't think about the money. Take your startup as your mission and celebrate failure.